Hi guys, how's it going? So, started playing this game last night, and at one point I completely and utterly bricked my economy, okay? So every single one of these resources was basically zero, and I kind of thought, well, is this it? Is this the game over now? But I did a bunch of stuff which actually kind of helped me get back on my feet. I think a large part of the problem was population for a start. So I kind of exterminated a lot of my population to reduce the number. So that kind of brung down things like my consumer goods and things. Okay, maybe it's a bit cruel, but you know, it kind of worked, I guess. The other thing I did is I went to my planets, okay? And the first thing I did was I got rid of all my research buildings, okay? Now they were all upgraded 3 or 4 times, so this was kind of painful. But yeah, got rid of all the research, basically reduced consumption, so I got rid of a whole bunch of other building, and I kind of reduced it down to the point I had unemployment, basically. So that means that I've got more workers than places where they can work. So again, that kind of reduced the cost a lot. Other things that you can try are, if you go to policies, then change your food policy to strict rationing, if you want to. That should kind of help reduce your food consumption. Trade policy, again, if you've got enough energy, you could always go for consumer benefits. I'm not going to really bother. Again, if you don't have enough consumer goods, go for a civilian economy, okay? Because, look, alloys are really, really good for, you know, building your fleet and stuff. But if you don't have, you know, a civilization to protect, then, well, it doesn't really matter, does it, I guess? Another thing I did was I had the most powerful fleet in the game, right? And it was beautiful. You should have seen it. It was amazing. So I deleted it, basically. I selected all my fleet and pressed the delete key. And unfortunately, they all kind of were deleted or disbanded. I kind of made them sort of go away. Now, I think the first thing I had was alloys. So I started to get a few alloys trickling in. And I actually tried to buy other resources. But it didn't really work. The other resources vanished after a while. To be honest, you don't have to exterminate your population. You can always try to dispel them or sort of just send them out, basically. So one of the decisions you can sometimes do is those discourage planetary growth if you want to. Or, it's not quite here, but there's sometimes an option for basically get rid of excess population. I had massive problems with crime, so my crime was really, really high, so I made deals with crime lords. You know, that's one resource that you should have is influence still, right? So, you know, bear in mind this might be useful when you fight to get back to good economic standards. Now, one of the big causes of economic instability is if you don't do enough trade with other players. So if you're kind of quite isolationist, then actually managing the economy is more difficult than if you're kind of open and trading with everyone. So if you can trade with other people, it's good to kind of do that because that improves overall stability. The other thing you can do is, I don't know how much it's going to help, but you could potentially get rid of some of these stations here. If you actually look here, scroll over your energy credits, for example, ships are costing me 191 per turn, stations 164 per turn, star base is 154 per turn, buildings 209, so buildings are a big one. So getting rid of, like I say, a lot of the buildings, especially things like research, which you don't actually strictly need, at least if you're trying to fix your economy. Getting rid of all the research, you know, is a really good way to go. I really hope that helped you guys. I managed to get back on my feet. It was in large part due to population. Now, the other thing you could potentially do is you could change the living standards of the population, but bear in mind, right, it's a delicate balance, right? Because if I were to go for decent conditions, right, that would reduce my consumer goods, but my population would be less happy, and that would actually mean that they would produce less, okay? Yeah, sometimes you have to do, you know, desperate things to kind of save the game. As you guys can see, economically, I'm actually doing very, very well. Because I deleted my army, one of my rivals, who had been beaten up, basically, decided to attack me. So they took all this area down here, right? Which isn't too bad, considering I actually have quite a big area up here to kind of balance that. Rebuilt my fleet when my economy was doing better. And I kind of retook the area that the enemy took, and I'm gonna kind of destroy the enemy here because, you know, why not? So in this particular game, I'll just go over it briefly. I've gone for two different strategies. So I've gone fanatic egalitarian, right? Which means you have to use democracy. It means specialist output is increased by 10%. Faction influence gain plus 50%. So that's kind of good. And xenophobe. So again, this is interesting because I've been playing a lot with nihilistic acquisition, right? Where pops can be, you know, taken from the enemy planet. And I actually think it was the nihilistic acquisition which partly damaged my economy because I took so many sort of people from here, from these guys. It kind of unbalanced my economy. Now, I set some of them to be slaves and I set some of them to sort of be exterminated as food or production, okay? But nevertheless, I still think it kind of dragged the rest of my economy down. Anyway, really hope you found this video useful and good luck in the future, guys. Hey guys, just wanted to give you a massive thank you for watching. If you like the video, please subscribe. Give this a thumbs up. If you didn't like it, give it a thumbs down. It's up to you entirely. But yeah, please let me know in the comments what you thought. And thank you very much for watching.